Greetings, welcome to Herodotus History. In this video, we will talk about an experimental gravel-based mounted armor developed for the American M4 Sherman tank. We all understand the brutal realities of tank warfare. Tanks, these steel giants, played a crucial role on the battlefield, but every year anti-tank weapons became more and more powerful. Anti-tank rocket launchers such as the German Panzerfaust and Panzerschrecks have become a real nightmare for tankers. After all, such anti-tank weapons could be used by both a child and an old man. The tankers did not want to die from a 15-year-old Hitler fanatic with Panzerfaust. Allied tankers and Soviet tankers, faced with this new threat, desperately searched for ways to protect their vehicles. Tracks, sandbags, and planks were hung on the armor. At first, everyone was convinced that the cumulative jet could be stopped with sandbags. Tankers, fearing for their lives, hung their tanks with tons of bags. On the screen, you can see examples of such additional armor, but as practice has shown, handheld grenade launchers easily penetrated sandbags. General Patton didn't like that tankers were doing such a useless thing that slowed down tanks. Therefore, he banned the use of this method. But General Patton and the other officers did not understand one simple thing. The tankers needed at least some hope that they could survive. There were even such desperate tankers who concreted their tanks. This method added more than 5 tons of mass to the tank, and its effectiveness has not been proven in any way. In 1943, the U.S. Army Armament Department began receiving information from the Eastern Front that the grenade launcher could penetrate heavy Soviet tanks. Panzerfaust armor penetration is 140 to 200 millimeter, and Panzerschreck armor penetration is 220 millimeter. No tank was able to stand up to them. Then in 1943, the U.S. Army Armament Department decided to take an unconventional route. Engineers began researching new armor materials that would provide the same level of protection with less weight. This is how the idea of using plastic armor came about. It was designated as HRC2, a mixture of aluminum filler, 50%, and a binder, asphalt with wood flour, or in a simpler version, gravel, 80%, with asphalt and wood flour. Additional protection for the tank was proposed to be constructed from separate elements of different shapes. Each such block was a box made of aluminum with walls and a bottom 25.4 millimeters thick. HRC2 was poured between the walls. The lids of the boxes were provided with brackets for suspension on the tank. Appropriate hooks were added to its armor. Suspension was accomplished with 12.7 millimeter steel cables. The aluminum and HRC2 overhead armor kit for the M4 Sherman weighed 8 tons. A steel armor kit with the same protection characteristics would have weighed more than 12 tons. A prototype set of the new armor was produced only in the fall of 1945. At the same time, a prototype based on the production M4 Sherman was tested at the Aberdeen Proving Grounds. In the course of the tests, it was determined by firing the rocket-propelled grenade launchers, Panzerschreck and Panzerfaust 100 are capable of damaging the combat module or even penetrating it, but after that, do not threaten the tank armor. The turret modules successfully coped with the shelling, while the hull side blocks were penetrated several times, but without hitting the tank. Despite some disadvantages, the gravel armor demonstrated the potential of using non-metallic materials in tank construction. Although this project was not realized during World War II, the ideas behind it were developed in the future. Overhead modules and combined armor systems with non-metallic elements became the de facto standard for modern combat vehicles. Gravel armor is a good example of how non-standard solutions led to a breakthrough in the military sphere. Thanks for watching. Write in the comments, would it be effective to use this additional armor in war? You can also support the channel by buying coffee. The link in the description. Have a nice day.